I would like to speak about the coronavirus and the future. Is there a future after this coronavirus? Many people are looking in horoscopes, going to persons who tell the future, pay a lot of money, looking in the crystal ball, laying cards to know their future. But to be honest, it doesn't tell the truth. The only truth we find in the Bible. And the Bible is the revelation of God who is in heaven, and God clearly told what is going to happen with mankind and with the earth. So, let's go and look into the Bible, what the Bible is telling us. And I have to be very fast to explain it, because it is a lot of things which I'm unable to explain all in this sermon, which already takes a long time. But I have to tell you a lot of things, so please stay with me and follow on with me. God took his people from the slavery from Egypt, our slavery of Satan, and liberated them and guided them into the promised land, our heaven. So, what did God tell the Israeli people? Well, God was very clear. He was very clear with Adam and Eve. If you eat from the forbidden fruit, certain you will die. And God was very clear with the Israeli people. If you worship me, you will have peace in the promised land without wars. If you reject me, fire. Adonai, outro Jesus, I worship other gods made by hands of stone, molded images, you reject me, now do not obey my commandments, you will receive wars, and you will be taken from the promised land. Well, that's exactly what happened. The Israeli people didn't want to know about God, his commandments, and they received wars. Still, they didn't listen, and in the end, they were removed and taken to Babylon. And in Babylon, there was a very wise man, a Jew, whose name was Daniel, and his wisdom was known, and he was placed under the government, the king Nebuchadnezzar. And the king Nebuchadnezzar ruled possibly the complete world. So let's look at Daniel. I'm going very quickly because Daniel is written for Israel. The period, the time of the church was hidden and nothing was known about the period of the church. So why Wilfred concerned about this? This is written for the Israeli people. Well, it might be written for the Israeli people. However, it tells us the exact days what is going to happen in the Great Tribulation. And the Great Tribulation is a near future, what is going to happen soon. So it is important to know the times, the days of what is going to happen, and it is the future. It's the future what is going to happen within days, months, 1 year, but I think at the most 2 years. So it is very important to know what is going to happen and to inform people, believers and unbelievers. That's our task as a pastor. So let's go to Daniel Setje and read it for yourselves. The verses 20 to 21. A time, times, and a half time. The time is 1 year, times is 2 years, and a half time is half a year. So total 3.5 years, the first of the great years of the great tribulation. Daniel 8, verse 14. 22,300 evenings and mornings. That's about 6.4 years. And verse 17 is relating to the final time, the end of the Great Tribulation. Daniel 8, verse 26, hide the vision because it sees to a future, a very long future. So, what's this very long future? Well, Daniel was lived about 620 years before the birth of Christ. We have already passed 2000 years since the birth of Christ. So this vision was given 2600 years ago. So we are living now in the final time. This vision will be fulfilled. I have to tell you something. I go very quickly. Six is the number of men and seven is the number of God. From Adam to the birth of Jesus is about 4,000 years. From the birth up to now is about 2,000 years. So 600 years are passing. The end, the fulfillment of mankind. So that will terminate, and the 7,000 years will come, and 7 is the millennium, 1,000 years of kingdom of Christ. So yes, we are completing the 600 years, the finish of mankind. Daniel 9, verse 24, 17 weeks, which is almost 6 years, the end will come. Verse 27, during a week he will reign, and in the half of this week he shall terminate the sacrifices. And where are the sacrifices brought? Exactly in the temple. The third temple will be constructed soon after the rapture of the church. So the third temple will be built soon, and Satan, the beast, will terminate the sacrifices in the temple. Daniel 12 verse 4 tells, seal this book until the final time. And the final time, that is the great tribulation. This book of Daniel and another book is also sealed. We don't know where these books are, but they are hidden. But we already discovered the books of the Dead Sea, and they prove to be the truth. There are almost no variations in what we have in the Hebrew and in the rolls of the Dead Sea. They are equal, so there is no deviation. So we, in this century, these books of the Dead Sea were found, so certainly these books will be found during the Great Tribulation, and which is sealed will be revealed. Daniel 12 verse 7, a time, a times, a half a time. Again, the 3.5 years of the final tribulation and all these things which are written will be fulfilled. So let's go to Daniel 7, Daniel 12, verse 10. Many shall purify themselves and make themselves white and be refined, but the wicked shall be wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand. But those who are wise shall understand. So all who are rejecting those, God, they will not understand. They will not understand the Bible, and only the wise persons who recognize God will understand. If you accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord, you receive the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will explain. But now, when you are home, you have the time to study the Bible, to read the Bible, investigate on television, listen to the preaching, listen to this sermon, and I'm trying to explain the coming weeks, months, Revelation. But only the wise who have the Holy Spirit will understand. Daniel 12, verse 11. And from the time that the continual burnt offering is taken away, and the abomination that makes desolate is set up, and there shall be 1290 days, which is approximately 3.5 years. Blessed is he who waits and comes to the 1335 days, which is 3 years and 255 days. If you count those together, you will come to 2625 days, which is about 7.3 years. That's the future. God is very clear, he gives exactly the days. Nothing hidden. The future is given. The exact days, how long the great tribulation will last. And remember that we are talking about 30 days in a month according to the Jewish calendar. And the end of Daniel tells, but go your way till the end, and you shall rest and shall stand up in the end of the days. So, God is telling Daniel, you will die, you will rest, and you will be resurrected at the end of the great tribulation, or the end of the millennium, we don't know, but at the end, there is the resurrection of the wise and the foolish, the ones who lived in the were believers, they will be resurrected to life and go to the new earth. And who rejected and didn't believe, they will be resurrected for eternity to the lake of fire. So, that are the exact days of the great tribulation, which is coming soon, and which is the future. So, let us go to Ezekiel 3, verse 17. Son of man, that's Ezekiel, I have made you a watchman for the house of Israel. Well, this is written for the house of Israel. What is telling here is that you, if you are a Christian, and I, are placed as a watchman for the world. Come back later on, but we are watchmen to warn and tell the future what is going to happen. I have made you a watchman for the house of Israel. Whenever you hear a word from my mouth, and we have the Bible, which is the word of God, you shall give them warning from me. We are obliged as Christians, as pastors, to proclaim the gospel in the future. It is going to happen soon. And if you say to the wicked, you shall surely die, and you give him no warning, nor speaks to warn the wicked, from his wicked way in order to save his life or her life, that wicked person shall die in his or her iniquity. But his blood I shall require at your hand. If we don't proclaim the gospel, if we are not warning the world what is going to happen, if you are not going to tell the future, God will require their lives, their blood from us. But if you warn the wicked and he doesn't turn from his wickedness or from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity. But you will have saved your own life. Again, if a righteous man turns from his righteousness and commits iniquity, and I say lay a stumbling block before him, and he shall die. So a Christian who knows all about the Christian life, about the commandments of God, and he turns away, goes living in the world, rejects the good, doesn't care about his proxima, about his neighbor, he surely will die. And what we need to understand by that die, I'm very careful, but the Holy Spirit is taken from him. He distinguishes the Holy Spirit, and if it means that he will pass through the tribulation or he is going to the lake of fire, I don't know, and I'm very careful about that. I will lay a stumbling stone before him, and he shall die, because you haven't warned him. So brothers and sisters, pastors, it is our task to warn the sinner to stop living in the world, to repent of sins, and his righteousness deeds which he has done shall not be remembered. But his blood, if he don't warn him, I will require at your hand. Nevertheless, if you warn the righteous man not to sin, and he does not sin anymore, he turns to living a Christian life, he shall sure live, because you took the warning, and you shall have saved your life. So let that be a warning. And I shall continue to your teachers, your professors, at the university, your pastors, your preachers, let's go to Mark 9, verse 22, 42. Whoever causes one of these little ones, the little ones is your congregation, your at the schools and universities, whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, you are the cause. You are the reason that they are going to sin. If you are proclaiming communism, socialism, gender, if you are causing them to sin, it would be better for him or her if a great millstone will hang around his or her neck and see or her was thrown into the sea. So don't be mistaken about the judgment of God if you are not proclaiming the truth. And you, student, use your intelligence. They are proclaiming to have an equal salary for everybody. Is that the truth? You earn a low salary, a slavery, and the person who reign in your country, in the communist world, Venezuela, Cuba, they are the rich people. Where is the equality? They are rich, and the poor people are starving, and they earn a very low salary. That's communism, that's socialism. You don't own your own house, everything is divided. But where is the division of these rich leaders? And in the communism, if you are caught as a homosexual, you are put into prison. So be careful when you believe in these things. And as a teacher at schools or at university, remember this first. God will require the blood of these innocent people. So that's the future. God is very clear what is going to happen with mankind and earth. So let's go to Revelation, the last book of the Bible. In Revelation 1, verse 3, it is written, blessed is he who reads aloud the words of this prophecy, the revelation to John, and blessed are those who hear and who keep what is written therein, for the time is near. You can say, well, the time is near, it is given 2000 years ago. But remember, Peter tells that 1,000 years is like a day for God. So, only 2 days has passed for God. And remember, I told you about it, the vision of the 4,000 years from Adam to Jesus Christ. And the time of the church, from the birds to now, which is 2,000 years or 2 years. So the time when this revelation was given to John is near. And God tells who preaches this gospel, proclaim the gospel, who proclaim these revelations, he will be blessed, and more blessed are the persons who study the revelation and study the word of God. He will be blessed. And also is stated, and will keep what is written in the book of Revelation. So let us take this to heart. And let's know the future. The future is the great tribulation is coming soon. And in Revelation, the revelation to John, the last book of the Bible, is described what is going to happen in the terrible tribulation. I will not go through it. I hope to spend the coming weeks to explain Revelation to you, but I will go to Revelation 11. Revelation 11 tells us but do not measure the court outside the temple, leave that one out, for it is given to the nations, and they will trample over the holy city, that's Jerusalem, for 42 months. And we already saw from Daniel those 42 months, or 3.5 years. And I grant my two witnesses power to prophesize for 1,260 days. Remember the exact time? God gives the future. He tells exactly for 1,260 days. They are granted the power to witness of God. And if anyone on earth will try to harm these two witnesses, fire will pour out their mouths and consume these fools. Fire will destroy. If they are trying to kill these two prophets, these two witnesses. They have the power to set the sky that no rain falls during the time they prophesize, and they have the power of the waters. Another translation tells us rivers and oceans to turn them into blood and to smite the earth with every plague as often as they desire. The future, 3.5 years, they will be witnesses of God, and they are capable of doing terrible things. What is written here? Take it to heart. Can order that no rain falls. In the south of Brazil, the last years, little rain falls, the water reservoirs are emptying, so people receive only one day per week water. They have to be careful with water, with showering, and in that heat of 30, 40 degrees, there's no pleasure to not be able to take a shower. Another thing, they can order that rivers and oceans turn into blood without water to drink. Can you imagine that? How terrible that will be? And they can smit the earth with every plague as often as their wishes. So this coronavirus, COVID-19, is nothing compared to what is going to happen in the first days, first 3.5 years of the Great Tribulation. So think well if you wish to pass through this Great Tribulation. Sorry to say, but this coronavirus, COVID-19, is nothing. This is just a warning and an announcement what is going to happen about the terrible diseases in the Great Tribulation. But Daniel was very clear about the time given by God, the time of the Great Tribulation is 2,625 days. This is a little more than 7 years. So this Great Tribulation, the power of Satan, the beast, the false prophet, with all these terrible things, we end. That's the future. That's what Scott is telling and to warn the people. So how do we know the end? The end is given in Revelation 20. Then I saw coming down from heaven, holding in his hand the key of the bottomless pit and the great chain. And he seized the dragon, the ancient serpent, who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. 1,000 years of the millennium of the reign of Jesus Christ, and threw him into the pit, and shut it and sealed it over him, that he should not deceive the nations no more, until the 1,000 years were ended, after which he, Satan, must be loosened for a little while. At the end of the Great Tribulation, there is the Great War. Jesus is coming back with the believers who are in heaven. They will fight Satan, the beast, the false prophet, and the beast and the false prophet will be thrown into the lake of fire. Only Satan will be thrown in the bottomless pit for 1,000 years. That will take place the kingdom of Jesus. In the kingdom for 1,000 years, there will be justice. There the people can experience how it is to be living under the kingdom of Jesus Christ. That's the end? No, it isn't. We need to continue in verse 7 of Revelation 20. And when the 1,000 years have ended, Satan will be loose from his prison, the bottomless pit, and will come out to deceive the nations, which are at the four corners of the earth, that is Gog and Magog, to gather them for battle. Their number is like the sand of the sea. Here are the wicked people who don't like to adore God, who don't like the justice in the kingdom of Jesus Christ. They reject Jesus Christ and they're following Satan. And they marched up over the broad earth and surrounded the camp of the saints and the beloved city, Jerusalem. But fire came down from heaven and consumed them. All those sent of the sea, all those wicked persons are consumed by the fire. And the devil who deceived them was thrown into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet already were. And they will be tormented day and night forever and ever, eternity. That's the future. Satan and his followers will go to be tormented day and night forever and ever. So make up your mind what you wish to do, to follow Jesus, adore, worship God, be obedient to the commandments of God given in the Bible, because the Bible is the truth and is telling us the future. The Bible is telling clearly what is going on in the world, what is happening. The coronavirus is a warning. Now God is giving the time to unbelievers to accept Jesus Christ as Savior, the richest, the righteousness person who has turned away from Christ to return, the believer to return, to live under the control of the Holy Spirit, and to accept Jesus Christ as Lord, and to be taken up at the rapture of the church. And if not, to stay behind in the great tribulation. And Revelation is clearly telling us what is going to happen in that great tribulation and the times are giving in Daniel. So please make the correct choice. It is up to you.